11 years ago, KCAL 9 launched a series of reports on the strange world of downtown Los Angeles. We expected it to be full of extremes, and it was.
You're gonna pay for bringing a Negro as a slave. You're gonna pay for getting the so-called Mexican.
$5, so I mean $5.
You're gonna pay for getting the so-called Indian, because we are the true nation of Israel, God's chosen people.
The city's original downtown core had just gone through 100 years of spectacular upheaval. It had been the center of business in Southern California. Every type of business, from department stores to banks to a trip to the dentist, everything was centered in a large and active downtown LA. But when we toured it in the early 1990s, that business center was long gone, replaced by strings of tiny discount shops that were leased by Central American merchants at exorbitant rent from a shadowy collection of building owners who had left their properties totally abandoned above street level. We found more than 200 buildings that had been empty since the early 1960s. As Channel 9 found out, no American city had ever been left in this condition on this kind of a scale. And we learned that from this man.
I think we're going to create a great city here.
Ira Yellen, attorney, businessman, and an enthusiast who had a vision for downtown. Ira Yellen loved what the city used to be, and it was his dream that people should now live in the places where people used to work. Ira Yellen saw the future.
I suspect it's going to become more of an international community. It won't be predominantly Hispanic, but it will be largely Hispanic. But I think eventually it'll reflect the diversity of Los Angeles as a whole.
Yellen started work on the first apartments to be constructed inside an old, empty office building. 3rd and Broadway had been the home of the Department of Water and Power, but we watched a decade ago as the building was transformed.
This is the boardroom itself, a magnificent wood-paneled room that'll now become the living room for one of the new apartments inside this building. It'll come complete with all the wood, the old original fireplaces, even the old stained glass windows that were used to close this room off when board meetings were being held. Everything will be here left just as it looked, really, all the way back to 1910.
Yellen pioneered what downtown is becoming today. This is now that same boardroom. It's an apartment overlooking a building boom that is sweeping all across the core of this city. Clearly, Ira Yellen had to take some very bold steps back in the day. His labor force had to battle plenty of street crime.
They broke into the truck just to dig through some papers in the back of the truck because there was nothing in the truck to steal. But they broke the side window out, which cost $200.
Broad daylight?
Broad daylight.
Twice?
Twice.
What was the second time?
Well, same window.
But the 60-unit building was quickly filled with renters, paying between $600 and $1,800 a month. The Yellen gamble had paid off. And others were watching.
Isn't lunch delicious? Isn't lunch the greatest thing here? Wouldn't you be willing to pay twice as much?
New York architect Tom Gilmore figured if Yellen could make one building work, he could buy 6 neighboring empty structures and turn them into today's old bank district. The buildings would be cheap, the renovation would not. But first, the city had to pass an important new law, adaptive reuse, which means exactly what it says. Tom Gilmore can buy J.B. Lankershim's San Fernando building on Main Street and adapt the office building to reuse it as apartments. It has been a 5-year struggle.
You know, the last 5 years, I've learned an awful lot about what we do, you know, and so that initial optimism and vision, or whatever you want to call it, does get tempered by the reality of how unbelievably difficult it was to actually make it happen. But the driving force that made me feel that way is still really present in how I feel. I mean, I actually am more optimistic today than I was then. I think then it was optimism and dreaming combined, and now I think there's actually a lot less dreaming and a lot more optimism based on what effectively has occurred and what will occur over the next 10 years.
Those years will probably be an accelerated version of what Tom Gilmore has already accomplished. Remember, Gilmore and Ira Yellen and some others who were in on the ground floor started in downtown Los Angeles with nothing. Abandoned space might look interesting, but the job of turning it into this kind of living area is huge. It is such a big undertaking that from 1998 until today, many involved in that transition fell by the wayside. Others survived. others thrived, which leaves people like Tom Gilmore part of the way to their goal.
Well, and people don't think I'm crazy anymore, which I think is a real plus, you know.